I'm excited to show it to you. Let's go take a look.
Hope everyone had a good weekend. Getting ready for Christmas. What's up?
This is actually the entertainment bay. In the quad slide, as you can see, you've got all that storage, but what you do is you open this cabinetry here, flip this guy like this, and then there is an actuator button right here that holds a 55-inch TV. How's our audio doing today?
Make sure that the audio is correct, and if it's whack, we take it back. I don't know what that means, but that's what we're doing. That's a nifty design right there. What it does is it achieves the largest TV for the entertainment bay in the industry. That's pretty cool, 55-inch. Okay, we're gonna close that up. We're gonna go inside. I was just out talking with Dave Bash. He's actually taking our sales manager, Mike LeBrosser, out, and you can see Armand can swing around and show you. There's a good old 1299. That's that double slide with the three bunks in it that's for sale. Dave's actually gonna take Michael out to do a drive. Michael is in driver's training with Dave. No one better to train you to drive than Dave Bash. And I've got the door open because it's such a nice morning here in Coburg for being the 20th of December. Really nice. Little bit of overcast, but shoot, it's pretty warm. All right, you guys, 1332, this is the cockpit. So Brenda was telling us that about the style of this. It's transitional. What does that mean? It's not traditional and it's not contemporary. It's right in the middle, meaning it's transitional. That's the way she described the style of this coach to us. And I know her and Alan have talked about what styles of coaches are many, many times. And so the best way to describe this is transitional, a little bit of contemporary and a little bit of traditional built into the both. So it's not necessarily modern, but it's not necessarily traditional. I don't know what that means, but we're gonna take a look. All right, here we are. Beautiful idea with a quad, man. There's so much room in this coach. When you jump from a double slide to a quad, it's always surprising, even to someone like myself who spends a lot of time in these coaches, how much room there really is in these coaches. There's so many different elements I like about this coach. This dinette top is really cool. It's got a backlit, kind of like a cracked glass look. For those of you who remember the old Formica kitchen tables of the 1960s, this is kind of the updated version of that, and it's backlit. That's really cool. The backsplash also kind of runs in that same theme. It kind of plays off of it. It's very, very pretty. Also, even though there's no windows in this portion of the galley, because that backsplash is so light and you've got lighting underneath here, it adds light to the entire coach. We're gonna go back this way, then we'll come back into the salon and look at a few more things. Storage right here, right next to the refrigerator and freezer, the Fisher-Paykel fridge and freezer. Here's the half bath right here and a closet with drawers right there. Take a look at this half bath. And you guys, you love to see this, because I do. This is a super bath with a sofa in the rear. So when they first designed this floor plan, I really liked this seating area. Now, there are different coaches that we've done that have the storage facility over here, or storage setup with a little bit of a higher deck and more storage. We saw it in coach 1305. We've seen it in a few others where they took the sofa out and put storage here instead. I do like the seating area, and it adds to, because it's a quad, it adds to the room as an actual room, because it's, you know, you can have guests back in your bedroom. For those of you who don't want guests back here, it does have a really nice seating area right here. I almost said facility. It has a really nice seating area, but also, you know, this can easily be changed over to more of a storage with a bench seating instead. But the sofa really is a cool design, really is neat. Storage below the bed, closet over here on Armand's left and on his right. But here's what everybody really likes to see. This is the super bath. And one thing about this floor that I want to show you is it goes from hardwood floors that starts all the way from the cockpit into this really great tile. And I've a lot of people would prefer the wood, but I really like what they did with the tile. It goes along with the cabinetry and the wall covering back here. It's just really, really pretty. So cool. All right, take a look at this shower. It's got that same tile work that you see in the half bath, in the backsplash of this super bath, and what you saw in the galley. So it's kind of a theme that runs throughout. That's another thing about the super bath. These showers, I'm going to jump in, something I've done from time to time on the show. This really shows just how much room is in the shower. And I'm, I'm 5'11", 6 foot. So it's really a big shower. It's got the rain shower head and the wand so that you have the ability to use two different water sources in that shower. That's a big room. The sinks in here are really, really nice. These are artisan deep bowl glass sinks. Very cool. Armand, I'm going to switch spots with you because I want to show everybody. When we first saw the super bath, when Jay Graham brought us down and showed us from an engineering standpoint this new floor plan a year, darn near a year and a half ago, you guys. I think 1296 was the first super bath. This wall right here behind the commode is set up, as you can see, as a closet. It's large, it's deep, but this is where the washer dryer goes. And it's always cool to see it before. It's pre-plumbed and it's ready. And when it sells, the owner or whoever purchased it will be able to make that decision. Keep it a closet if they don't want a laundry facility in their coach, or put the washer dryer in. And then, just when you think the super bath is over, you get this additional closet in the back. 4 foot hanger bar, and on each side it's got pantry. It's got
hampers.
Thank you, Armand. I love the fact that it's got so much room in here. It's such usable room too. It's not just a large bath, it's a usable bath. So very, very cool. I also like how this tile extends through into the closet. It's just a really cool look with that. This is a very elegant coach. I'm a big fan of the color of the walls. Even the lighting sconces are kind of that cracked glass look or effect, which plays off of not only the dinette tabletop that we saw, but also the backsplash. This bedspread's pretty too. Let's close this door and see what Brenda has behind here. Oh, that's cool. So you got a mirror here, and then three photos here on this wall. and this is what the room looks like when it's closed up. And of course, 90% of the time, these pictures will be customized when someone purchases the coach. Back into the galley and salon. You know, the entertainment value in a marathon, you've got TVs everywhere. This coach has two TVs up here in the salon, a large TV in the bedroom, and we've already seen the 55-inch in the entertainment bay. So you've got four TVs. This TV is dual functioning, in my opinion, because it can swivel out for people that are sitting on the curbside or the patio side of the coach. They can sit in these recliners and they can have this TV at any angle that they would prefer it be at. Or if someone's over here in the dinette, they can have it all the way flush against here. And that's really nice. It's simple, but it's extremely usable for anyone sitting anywhere in the salon because it has quite the 90 degree angle. Sleeper sofa right here. Excuse me, let's make that jackknife. Yes, it jackknifes down to a sleeper. So if you've got someone who's hanging out or wants to take a nap in your coach, you've got that there. Heated floors, of course, throughout. And here's more of the cracked glass on top of this, right behind the driver, on top of this, which is where the fireplace is. And that's about it, you guys. This is this guy's for sale, and this one is going to be, you know, $1,332. This is a quad that is ready. Here we are with what, 10, 11 days to go before the end of the year. If you're looking to get into a marathon, Mal W at marathoncoach.com. If you're looking to upgrade, if you're looking to trade in, this coach is ready. If you're thinking, hey, I want to get into a coach before the end of the year, or hey, in January, I want to take off and do whatever. I don't want to fly. I don't want to be in a hotel. 1332 is ready right now for delivery. Dave Bash is here. You could do a delivery literally within 24 hours. Reach out to me. Let me know what you're thinking. Be yourself and do good things. Thanks again for watching this show every single week. Next week is our 200th episode, and Armand and I were talking about it briefly. We love this Facebook live format because it gives you guys who are researching, who are even for a lot of you who are just fans of marathon, it gives you the ability to see an unedited version of what's going on with marathon this week, whether it be here at the factory where, you know, we've been here a lot this year because of COVID. We haven't been able to travel. There's not been a lot of shows. There hasn't been a lot of events away from the plant. But we're coming up on the new year. I'm going early January. Jim Cogley and I will be down in Indio, California. So we'll bring you some live shows from down there. But thank you for supporting this format. Thank you for supporting Armand and myself doing this show. 200th episode is next Monday. It's the day after Christmas, and we will be live. We will be live, and the Monday after Christmas. Thank you. The Monday after Christmas, right before the new year, we're going to be live on our 200th episode, walking around the plant. So if you have any questions about the plants, things that you want to see, I want you to email me. Malw@marathoncoach.com. Email me this week, and Armand and I, as we walk around, maybe Armand, I'll print those suckers off. If you guys email me, I'll print them off. I'll carry them with me so that we can go and see different departments, and we'll just make a fun thing out of our 200th episode. Now, calendars, they are coming. I'm not able to show them to you yet. Want to make sure that the marathon owners get them first. So, with that in mind, don't email me yet about calendars, guys, because we're going to do something fun to get you those calendars. But I do not have them yet, so I cannot take your requests yet. So just stand by. I know we're coming up on the new year. I will get, I will do something fun to get you guys calendars. Other than that, let me know if you're interested in 1332. This is a great coach. Be yourself and do good things. Have a good week. Have a Merry Christmas. Take care of each other. Be safe. And we'll see you for our 200th episode next Monday. See ya. I did a lot of clapping today, didn't I?